from me. Tell me, Amy, why do you still insist on coming knocking on my door when you know how just...
The Amy that 36-year-old Dylan Duncan writes and sings about is not a love that was lost. Amy is short for amyloidosis, as in transthyretin-mediated amyloidosis, or ATTR, a rare debilitating disease which he inherited and is now battling.
In this Behind the Mystery, Rare and Genetic segment, we'll examine this metabolic disease.
The Balancing Act's Christopher Cox traveled to Boston for some insight from Dr. John Berk, Associate Professor of Medicine at Boston University and Clinical Director of its Amyloidosis Center. And that's where we also met Dylan Duncan.
Dylan Duncan is a songwriter and musician. He's also one of 50,000 patients impacted by transthyretin-mediated amyloidosis, or ATTR.
I went in for my genetic testing at the age of 26, and so I found out I had the gene for the disease, and a year later I went in and got a fat pad biopsy, which was then determined, which was used to determine whether or not symptoms had started.
Dylan Duncan has been John Berk's patient for nearly 8 years. They know each other well.
We met first in 2007, and at the time he was, I think, 27 years old. He had watched his mother become ill and undergo a liver transplant and subsequently die.
Disease symptoms may vary dramatically. Imagine having various symptoms of the disease, yet doctors are unable to find the cause of your specific condition.
ATTR is a hereditary disease that culminates in injury to nerves in particular, and secondarily to heart.
Dylan was 27 when he was diagnosed, but for him, it came as no surprise.
How old was your mother when she was actually diagnosed?
I want to say 37, 38. I know she was sick for about 5 years, and she passed away when she was 45.
The abnormal gene is passed from a parent to the patient. And it's approximately a 50-50 proposition every time an affected parent has the child.
My grandfather had lost his wife to the disease, and so he knew very well how dangerous it was. As his two daughters, you know, became sick, he was just very aware of the need for both my sister and I to get tested for amyloidosis. And so when I was 26 and I called him up and told him that I received a positive diagnosis of having the gene, he cried. He was very emotional about it.
Doctor, what are the symptoms of ATTR?
People will typically develop some burning, tingling, or numbness initially of their toes, and there is evolution up the leg till they reach approximately knee involvement, at which point their fingertips and hands become involved. There can also be remarkable dysfunction of the GI tract so that diarrhea or profound constipation can be problematic.
Back when I was like really worried about symptoms showing up, I was, you know, I would be in the shower and I would put my leg in the hot water to see if I could feel it. So some days if I wasn't feeling anything in my legs, I didn't know. But that's what sent me off into figuring out, you know, whether or not I had it or not. First symptoms that I was experiencing of amyloidosis were the carpal tunnel, which is that what they say I think 1 in 4 patients experience. But it was very strange. Like I would feel like a complete numbness in my entire arm, and I'd have to hang my arm over the bed just to get the feeling back. And that happened around 26, 27. That's why I went in to get tested. Things were starting to develop with my, you know, gastrointestinal issues and numbness in my calves I was experiencing. I've heard that a lot of the numbness will happen kind of starting in the feet and going upwards.
There's some competing diagnoses, ones that have very similar symptom complex, and as a consequence, neurologists will turn to those diagnoses without considering amyloid.
While currently there are no drugs specifically approved for ATTR in the United States, there are limited treatment options.
There are clinical trials ongoing right now that are focused on not simply stabilizing the abnormal protein, but eliminating it completely.
New treatment options currently under development may give ATTR patients and their families hope for the future.
I do have to get a hold of your sister, and I hope things are going okay.
We imagine a world where patients with ATTR are living full, healthy, high-quality lives. But it's important for patients to get involved. Diagnosis is critical, so we ask patients to get heavily involved in their diagnosis and bring others, if they in fact do get diagnosed with TTR-mediated amyloidosis, in, because it is a dominant autosomal inherited disease.
Dylan Duncan continues to perform his favorite hobbies, such as painting. He also enjoys hanging with his group of supportive friends, and of course, he continues to play his guitar.
There's one particular song that you wrote called Hello Amy. Tell us about that song.
Amy is short for amyloidosis, and so what I did is I actually wanted to just personify it and make it almost sound like it's a girl that you want out of your life, like an ex-girlfriend or something like that, you know?
Hello, Amy, I didn't expect you here this soon. You're not due for quite a while.
Are you still hopeful about your condition and ultimately yourself and your life?
Yes, very much so. There are moments when I get really, really scared, especially since symptoms are starting to kind of show themselves, and it's hard not to think negatively sometimes, just seeing what happened with our mother. And but absolutely, I mean, there are so many new advances that weren't happening around the time that my mom was, or if they were, at least they weren't, you know, being so widely explored, and it's very encouraging and very hopeful.
His music takes on new meaning. Gone are the Hello Amy lyrics. Today he sings about,
I could offer you my ears, they are open wide for you.
A special thank you to Dylan for sharing this personal story with us this morning, and thanks to everyone for sharing this information on ATTR.
For more information on the free third-party screening program, go to ttrscreen.com or call toll-free 1-855-338-3721.